Hello friends, my name is Nihir Mandora and welcome to the third part in the series of tutorial of learning grammar. Please take a pen or pencil and a book. If you find anything new, please write in it. You will learn quickly by doing it. Pause the video or rewind it if you don't get any concept. To get most out of this video, please watch it till the end. Okay, so let's get started. Firstly, we will remember what we have learned already. In the first video, we discussed about nouns and their two classifications. Which were they? First one was proper noun and common noun, and second one was collective noun. Then in the second grammar lesson, we discussed about the third category of noun, that was countable noun and uncountable noun. If you haven't watched those videos, I would highly recommend you to watch those videos first. I have given the links in the description. Now let's look into the last category of nouns, that is concrete nouns and abstract nouns. First, concrete nouns. Concrete nouns are nouns that can be identified from any of our five senses. Now, what are our five senses? We touch through our hands. We taste through our tongue. We hear through our ears. We see through our eyes. And we smell through our nose. Concrete noun can be proper noun, common noun, collective nouns, and countable and uncountable nouns. Let's see example to make things clear. Compare the examples with any of our five senses. Touch, smell, hear, see, and taste. Example: everyone likes a puppy. Right? You can touch, see, hear its barking, and smell its odor. So puppy is a concrete noun. You can touch, see, taste, and smell a pizza. And yes, no one wants to hear a noise. Here, you are using your ears as a sense. So, a puppy, a pizza, and noise, all three comes in the category of concrete nouns. Let's see sentence examples of the concrete nouns. First, Sam has nice mobile. Here, Sam and mobile are concrete nouns. Ajay's voice is excellent. Here, Ajay and voice are concrete nouns. He goes to school every day. Here, school is a concrete noun. I hope you are clear with concrete nouns. Now let's look into another category of noun, that is abstract noun. So what are abstract nouns? Nouns that cannot be identified from any of our five senses, which are touch, taste, sight, hearing, and smell. You cannot identify abstract noun with these senses. Now you might be wondering, what are these kind of nouns? Basically, these nouns define three things: idea, quality, and state of mind. Let me give you examples of each of them. Idea. When you are sleeping and any dream comes to your mind, what's that? It's an abstract term. You cannot see, smell, hear, taste, or touch your dream. You just have an imagination. Same way, quality. You might be having quality of being very kind. It denotes that you are a very good person. But you cannot use your five senses for understanding that. State. It defines your state of mind. Here in the image of the girl seems very happy. See, here also you cannot see your five senses to get the state of girl. Basically, they are feelings that any person has. Let's see some examples. Rohit is very intelligent boy. Here, intelligence defines the quality of Rohit. So, it is an abstract noun. our friendship will last forever. Here, friendship defines the relationship between us. So it is an abstract noun. It is my pleasure to welcome you. So you cannot touch pleasure or hear its noise. So pleasure is an abstract noun. Now let's see combination of both kind of nouns, that is concrete noun and abstract noun. Sam is a very emotional person. Here, Sam and person both are concrete noun and emotional is an abstract noun. Rina is a beautiful girl. Here, Rina and girl are concrete noun while beautiful is an abstract term. Ajay got an idea to create a mobile. Here, Ajay and mobile both are concrete noun, while idea is an abstract noun. So that's all in this video. What we have learned in this video? We discussed about concrete nouns. So concrete nouns are things you can see, smell, touch, taste or hear. And we discussed about abstract nouns. So abstract nouns are things that defines an idea, quality or state of mind. So now we have covered all the categories of nouns that we discussed in the first video. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any questions or suggestions, please write in the comment section. If you liked it, please hit the like button. Do share the video so others can learn. And do subscribe to this channel to get regular updates about the course.